Hey everybody, welcome to this Sunday. What Sunday is it? Well, it's a holiday Sunday, isn't it? We got something happening this week that's supposed to be fun. Is it Easter? No. Valentine's Day. It's Valentine's Day weekend, isn't it? No? Is it Administrative Assistant Appreciation Week? No? No, but that's a good one. What holiday is it? That's right! It's Christmas! We are gonna celebrate Christmas this week! It's gonna be awesome! And I know we're gonna have fun today in church. So, we're doing some cool stuff today. So, we've got some new friends that are gonna meet with us. And I know that you're gonna enjoy all that's gonna happen today in church. So, without further ado, let's check in with some of our new friends right now.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight! Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh! Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh!
Because Christmas is coming soon. I absolutely love the decorations, the lights, the music. It's such a fun and festive time of year. But before I talk about Christmas, I want to talk to you about two words that I have been thinking a lot about lately. What if? We have all had what if questions before. There are some things I have always wondered, like what if birds were afraid of heights? I mean, they certainly wouldn't fly.
No, no, no. I'm not jumping off of here. It's too high. I mean, if I get hit by a plane or something, it would be horrible. No way!
Or what if everybody on Earth jumped all at once?
Yippee!
What happened? Did we break it?
Or have you thought, what if money really did grow on trees?
No way! I'm gonna be so rich!
There are many what-if questions that we all have. But when it comes to Christmas, I had a what-if question the other day that totally blew my mind. What if the shepherds weren't invited to the manger? What if it were only the wise men who brought the gifts? The shepherds were just ordinary people. They were just like you and me. They weren't rich scholars like the wise men. They didn't have any gifts to bring the baby Jesus. They were just poor shepherds who heard an angel choir announce the birth of the King of Kings. But what if? What if God hadn't invited the average, the ordinary, the regular people to come to the manger? Thankfully, that didn't happen. Today, you're going to hear the story of that first Christmas day where the shepherds were invited to the manger where Jesus was laid. As you hear that story, I want you to think about how awesome it is that God sent his son not only to the important people, but to all people. What an amazing Christmas gift Jesus, the Son of God. Well, it's time for me to get back to decorating for Christmas, and it's time for you to get into your lesson. I'll see you next time. Merry Christmas!
Imagine that there is a new king being born. Not that one. No, but not just any king, though that it's an important king. In fact, it's the most important king ever being born. His arrival was going to change the entire world in ways that nobody could ever imagine. So let's say that you were put in charge of making the invites. You know, you're going to invite people to the birth to check this new arrival out. Let's say that you are put in charge of sending out the invitations. Who would you invite? Would you invite the president? Maybe some kings of other countries? Maybe the Burger King? Maybe there's like movie stars or some sports stars you'd invite. You know, people who could bring some cool gifts to the king, you know? That might be who I would invite, yeah. Well, as we're talking about the birth of Jesus today, you know, it's about Christmas, God didn't send invites to only the rich people. In fact, we're going to talk a lot today about how God sent his invitations to some of the poorest of the world, and they were the ones that got to see the birth of a king, man. And that tells us a whole lot about what Jesus came to do on this earth. So stick with us as we continue along our study today, and let's check in with our What You Gotta Know.
What you gotta know? What you gotta know? What you gotta know? What you gotta know?
Hey there, kids. I'm Big Ray, and I'm here to tell you what you gotta know. Today, we are talking about one of my all-time favorite subjects, Christmas. So today, every time you hear somebody ask you what you gotta know, you tell them Christmas is to celebrate Jesus was born. Christmas is fun. You know, with all the gifts? For me, you shouldn't have. And the snow? Woo! Burr! It is freezing out here. And all that fun stuff. But as fun as all that is not the reason we celebrate Christmas. Nah, it sure isn't. No, the reason we celebrate Christmas is because Jesus, God's son, was born in a manger. He is the reason for the season. And that right there is what you gotta know. This is Big Ray. And I'll catch you on the flip side.
What you gotta know?
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let repeat the sounding joy.
and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his
Today's Bible story is one that is filled with a ton of surprises. You know, there are a lot of Christmas songs that deal with our topic for today, the real Christmas story. It all starts with a group of shepherds who were taking care of their sheep in the middle of a field late one night. You know, I imagine that taking care of sheep was a pretty boring job because, well, sheep aren't very exciting. Sheep don't do much. They just kind of are there. And a shepherd's main job is to keep them safe. And so there wasn't a lot going on for the shepherds, and I'm sure most nights it was just boring. But in our story, the shepherds were about to get a huge surprise. In fact, it was the biggest surprise of their lives. Suddenly, up in the sky, appeared a huge group of bright, shining angels. They spoke to the shepherds. They said, "Guys, do not be afraid. We bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people, to everybody, for all of eternity." Big news. The shepherds were so amazed at what they saw. See, the angels began to sing, "Glory to God, glory to God." Well, probably was better than that. But they sang, "Glory to God in the highest." They told the shepherds all about baby Jesus and where they could find him in a tiny town called Bethlehem in a manger. See, the baby Jesus was the Son of God who had come to earth to take away the sins of all people. But then just as quickly as the angels came, they disappeared. They were gone. The shepherds didn't know what to do. They were amazed. They looked at each other and were like, should we, they decided, okay, let's go. We can't sit here. This has got to be something awesome. So they went to Bethlehem to see what had happened. They ran as fast as they could. They were booking it all the way down to Bethlehem. The shepherds headed straight for the stable where Mary and Joseph were. See, Mary and Joseph had to stay in a stable because there was no room in the inn. You know, this past Wednesday night, we watched the movie The Star, and they had cows in the stable. There was a horse in the stable. There was a cross-eyed goat in the stable, at least in the movie, and it was funny. But, you know, it may not have been just like that, but we do know that in the stable there were a lot of animals. And we know that Jesus was placed in a feeding trough for animals. That's what he was put in, wrapped in cloth and placed in a manger. The shepherds, well, they got to see a surprise that night. Not only did they see the angels come from heaven to declare the message that everyone had been waiting for, that their king had finally arrived, but when they found their king, he wasn't wearing gold chains and a crown on his head, but he was a baby wrapped in cloth lying in a feeding tray. That was a huge surprise. But that was a beautiful surprise. See, the shepherds, they were the surprise guest at Jesus' birth. When God sent out the invitation, when he sent out the invites to who could come to Jesus' birth, the shepherds were the first ones to get it. They gathered around Jesus, the Savior of the world, and the Bible says they worshiped Him. The shepherds learned that day that Jesus had come for all people. The angels appeared not to the most important people of the day, but to some of the most ordinary, some of the lowest, to some of the poorest people of that day, the shepherds. They showed the world that God sent His Son to the world to save the whole world, not just the famous people or the rich people. In our lesson today, we're going to learn that God doesn't see people as important or unimportant. He doesn't see people as rich or poor or fancy or not fancy or worthy or unworthy. God sees us all the same way. And He sent His Son to all people so that to save everyone from their sins if they follow Jesus. That's the best Christmas gift of all. And that's what we're learning about today.
Now, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born King of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose, and have come to worship him." And behold, the star went before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. And when they saw the star, they were overjoyed. And on coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him.
Our power verse today is Luke chapter 2, verse 11. And it says, "The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David." What an awesome announcement that was made by the angels to the shepherds. And that is a call for all people to know that Jesus is here. And that same message that was shared 2,000 years ago in the city of Bethlehem is also shared with you and me today. Jesus is here, and He's ready to help you and to love you and to be with you through everything you're going through. He is here for you, and that's what makes Christmas so awesome. We're not remembering something that happened 2,000 years ago only. We're also getting to remember that it's also something that's awesome for today. So, that's what our power verse is today, and it's going to help us as we go on through our time today. We'll see you in a minute. Today, we are talking about the very important question of, what if? Well, now I know there are a lot of random what ifs out there, like, what if it was against the law to eat vegetables? Yeah, I would be okay with that one. What if snails could run as fast as cheetahs and be super slimy at the same time? What if bumblebees had frog legs? That would be crazy. Or what if every Friday everybody got to eat ice cream for free? That would be super cool. This is a cool what ifs, and I'm sure you could come up with some pretty awesome what ifs. But today I have a what if question for you. What if the shepherds were not invited to the very first Christmas celebration? What if? Well, the reason this is such a big question is because it's a peculiar way of how humans naturally think. You know, we tend to put people on different levels. You know, we put like famous politicians up here, like the president. We put like movie stars up here, athletes up here, people with lots of money over here somewhere. And then we put like normal people down here, and then like people who don't have very much we put here, and then people who have less than we do we put down here. We tend to put people on levels, don't we? We do. And if we were to put the shepherds on a level, we'd put them down way down here. So what if Jesus didn't invite them to his Christmas celebration? You know, we tend to ignore the not so important people, don't we? We tend to, act like they don't exist, maybe. We treat people according to their levels. If we were to meet a famous athlete, I mean, we would be like, "Woo, yeah, I'm your biggest fan. I love you. I want to be your brother. Can you give me money?" We'd be like that, you know? And if we met somebody who maybe was different than us and wasn't famous, we might tend to be like, "Stay away from me. Get away." You know, we do that, don't we? You know, we treat people according to the level at which we put them at. But that's not the way God thinks. Thankfully, that certainly is not how God looks at his people when he chose to send his son as a tiny little baby. You see, Jesus came for the important people. Remember the wise men in our Christmas story? Oh yeah, remember these guys? Remember them? The Bible calls them wise men. They're also called kings, and we have a song called "We Three Kings of Orient Are." You got to sing it like that, or it doesn't count. So you got to hold your wrist like this. You got to sing it like that, because that's how kings would do it, like that. Mm-hmm. They always hold their vest like this. So hold it like that. So, you know what I'm talking about here? They were scholars. They were smart people. They were rich people. They had lots of money. They got Christmas songs about them. They're called kings. They're called "We Three Kings." Here's something to blow your mind. You know that we don't know how many kings there actually were. And we say there were three kings because they brought three gifts. But there could have been like 10 kings. And they just brought three gifts because the other seven forgot theirs on the camel. We don't know. There could have been two kings. There could have been one. There could have been 17. We don't know. But we do know there was three gifts. And so, these three gifts, they brought expensive gifts to Jesus all the way from far away lands. We know that Jesus did come for important people like the three kings. It makes sense to us because the wise men were on a higher level than many other people. They had lots of money, lots of fame. They were more important than most everybody else. Of course Jesus came to earth to save these important people and many others like them. But important people are not the only ones Jesus came to save. Remember the shepherds? Remember the ones that the angels came to? They were definitely not considered important. Nobody paid attention to shepherds. I mean, nobody. If you wanted to hide in Israel back then, be a shepherd. Because nobody would look for you. They wouldn't know where to find you. You were out in the field all day and all night. You know, you had a pretty solitude life. If you'd like to be alone, you'd have loved to have been a shepherd. Because nobody cared about shepherds. Nobody thought about shepherds. They worked in the middle of the night. Nobody thought very much about shepherds. They were average, they were ordinary, they were poor, they smelled like sheep. And if you ever smelled a wet dog, I bet that's what a wet sheep smells like. It's bad. You can't imagine a more not so important people than shepherds. But God paid special attention to those not so important people, didn't he? God sent an entire choir to invite them to come meet Jesus. They came and sang to him. It was awesome. He had just been born. The first people. Jesus didn't call a doctor over first. No. He called shepherds over. You know, he knew what he was doing. And they came and they bowed before Jesus. They worshiped him. He called the shepherds before the wise men. They were the first to arrive at baby Jesus' side. Isn't that amazing? Even though other people didn't think they were worth very much, God certainly did. God knew that the shepherds were very important in his eyes. Well, what does that teach us? This is a shepherd's hook, by the way. What does that teach us? What can we learn from that? It teaches us that whether you're rich or poor, famous, not famous, important, not important, in the eyes of others, it really doesn't matter. Because in the eyes of God, you're amazing. In the eyes of God, you are awesome. You are loved. And God is crazy about you. He sent Jesus for the unimportant just as much as he sent him for the important. He sent him for all of us. It doesn't matter what others say about you. And it doesn't matter of what you think about yourself. God loves you. God says you are worth it. You are worth him sending his son to earth to save you from your sins. In fact, Jesus came to save all people from their sins. See this globe right here? I don't know if you could see it in here. Like right over here is Israel. Like right here, little tiny country that changed the world. Jesus came right there. And this is look at all the places here we have where we live here. North Carolina over here, North America, and there's Canada, and there's South America. And over here we have China and India, Saudi Arabia. We got a lot of countries, all of Europe right here. Every person on earth, red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world. See, the song had it all right the whole time. Jesus came for everybody on earth. Jesus loved every person so that every person could be saved from their sins. Whether you're a prince from Europe or a poor child in Africa. Whether you are a famous king of Asia or a garbage man in South America. God loves you just the same, and Jesus came for you. During the Christmas season, let's remember that God loves all people the same. Don't think that you don't deserve as much as someone else. Don't think that only important people deserve Jesus' love, but I don't. No, that's not true. You're lying to yourself. Because Jesus loves you just as much as he loves everyone else. You are awesome. You are important to him. To him, everyone is important. So as we celebrate Christmas, let's celebrate the fact that Jesus came for everyone. And that's an awesome story, isn't it? Christmas is for everyone. Jesus' love is for you and for me. Well, I'm excited about celebrating Christmas this week. We're going to have so much fun at our house. Getting to open Christmas presents, singing Christmas songs, making Christmas goodies, and eating Christmas goodies because I like to eat. And I know you're going to have fun too. But let's not forget the reason we celebrate Christmas. It's not about the presents. It's about Jesus and about what he did for us. He came to this earth as a baby. He chose to do it so that he could live a perfect life. And he chose to die on the cross for our sins so that we could go to heaven one day. If it wasn't for Christmas, we couldn't have any of the rest of the story. And that story is for you and me just as much as it's for every boy and girl, man and woman across the globe. Let's pray. Jesus, we thank you so much for loving us, for dying on the cross for our sins, and for coming to this earth as a baby. And Lord, we just thank you so much that your story of love, you brought it to the lowest people on earth, the shepherds. It reminds us that you love us all. Those of us who are unimportant and the important people too. You love us all equally. And all of us can choose to follow you and to love you back. Jesus, thank you so much for Christmas. And help us remember that you are the true meaning of Christmas this year. We love you, Lord. And we thank you for loving us. In your name we pray. Amen. Hey guys, don't forget that we are still meeting in person here at Unity Church on Sundays and Wednesdays. Well, until we meet you again, you guys have a blessed week and an awesome and Merry Christmas. Bye-bye.